Permit me to say at this stage that Africa deals with diversity much better than Europe. Much better. If you look at your typical European nation, the Dutch is the Dutch, largely. The Swedes are the Swedes, largely. The Norwegians are the Norwegians, largely. The Finns are the Finns, largely. And where they have many ethnicities, they don't do very well. Ask the Spaniards if you doubt me. Where they had many nations in Yugoslavia, ask them. They created many nations to create pure ethnicities. But African nations have succeeded thus far in working with diversity in very unique circumstances where the conceptual West, despite their protestation to the contrary, are always interfering in our affairs in a very subtle manner. When we are holding election, they will deny it. But there is a way in which they are always moving in a subterranean fashion. Because the thesis still is that you divide them in order to rule them. That is the thesis. We don't say it as loudly as we should because we want to be politically correct, and I refuse to be correct. And this is exactly what Kwame Nkrumah warned us about. Africa's long-term salvation demands that we avoid adversarial politics. Africa's salvation demands that we define for ourselves what democracy means. What people want is to participate. What people want is to have a government that is accountable. Many people in many African countries simply want food on the table. Many people in many African countries simply want to have access to health care. Many people simply want good education. Young men and women in Africa simply want opportunities for innovation and invention. And they want a government that creates an environment where that can be achieved. And therefore, in my view, I think the time has come that Africa must define herself. One of the problems that we have in Africa is that we do not define ourselves. And permit me to annoy you. In many African nations today, after every election, whether we like it or not, we have observers. And when the elections are being held, observers may come from Nigeria, from Kenya, from Uganda, but people are waiting. What did the European Union say? You know, this belief by us that the Europeans have a divine duty to tell us what to do and we have a divine duty to accept to do what they say is one of the problems that we have. And until the day that we liberate ourselves to decolonize our minds, in a manner of speaking, we are going to embrace the kind of politics that will only perpetuate conflict.